स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल फॉर इजी लर्निंग ऑफ डेंटिस्ट्री थ्रू डेंट लर्निंग। दिस टॉपिक इज इन कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ थियरीज ऑफ ग्रोथ ऑर्थोडोंटिक्स। इफ यू डिडंट फॉलो माय प्रीवियस वीडियो, द लिंक इज मेंशन्ड इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बिलो। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डील विद द अदर टू थियरीज। दे आर जेनेटिक थियरी एंड सोशल थियरी इन डिटेल। विदाउट एनी फर्दर डिले, लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। जेनेटिक थियरी, दिस वॉज पुट फॉरवर्ड बाय एलन ब्रूडी। As we all know, genes play a very important role in growth and development. Putting this in mind, Alan Brody put forward the concept of genetic theory. This is very easy to remember and it is simple. All the growth is controlled by genetic factors and is pre-planned. This is nothing but it states that the growth is controlled by genetic factors and it is pre-planned. However, this theory was not accepted worldwide. This is one of the earliest theories which has been put forward. Sutural theory was given by Swisher. According to him, the craniofacial growth occurs at suture. This theory explains that connective tissue and the cartilaginous joints of the skeleton are the principal site for the primary growth of the bones. Okay, and he also explained by taking an example of the cranial vault. The cranial vault grows by expansive proliferative growth by the sutural connective tissue that forces the bones to move away from each other, hence leading to the increase in size of the cranial vault. And here in this picture, he explained that the circummaxillary sutures bring about a forward and downward movement of mandible by their growth. You can appreciate here, these circummaxillary sutures, when they are growing, they are moving the mandible downward and forward. Here you can appreciate these arrows. These will show the downward movement of the mandible due to the growth in circummaxillary sutures. And he also explained that mandible is essentially a bent long bone with mandibular condyles as epiphyseal plates of long bone, whose growth forces the mandible downwards and forwards away from the cranial bends. Hope you understood it. And this theory also has few drawbacks. They are, when an area of suture is transplanted to another location, the tissue does not continues to grow. This is one of the drawback. And one more drawback is that growth takes place in untreated cases of cleft palate, even in the absence of the sutures. These are few drawbacks. Hope you understood the theories. We will be discussing the remaining theories in my coming videos in details. So stay tuned. If you didn't subscribe to my channel yet, then smash the subscribe button and hit a like and drop a comment. It will really make my day. So keep learning with Dent Learning. Bye bye.